Hey, it's Jonathan here, founder of Draven Academy, and we're getting closer to Halloween, so I want to tell you a spooky story. Now, you see the ghost behind me, which means this is going to be real spooky, so you definitely want to hide the kids if they're watching. That being said, this story is going to be titled The Spooky Story of the Person Who Went to the Wrong Driving School. So, let me tell you, we're going to keep the names discreet for people's privacy, but we're going to call this person James. So, James was a person who really had the desire to get himself a CDL license. And he was looking at every which way to get a CDL license. He was looking at schools that he can go to. He was looking at free programs. He was looking all over the country. And he actually lived in Jersey. So what James decided to do is he wanted to save as much money as possible. And he wanted to get it done as quickly as possible. So he actually found a place out in California where he would go to a school where I'm not sure how much James actually paid. But he paid much cheaper than he found anywhere else. He also, English was a second language for him, so English was very, very tough for him to understand. So he went to a school that would help him out with his written test and with the road test and everything like that. And pretty much those kind of schools we call driver mills. So they don't really teach you anything. They're just kind of walking you through the process, making sure that you pass the test, kind of giving you the answers. And then from there, they kind of have sneaky ways of getting you your license, let's say that. But pretty much they don't care really about training you, they just care about the money, and they just want to push you through their program as quickly as possible so they can get the next person in. And usually they pack, usually people who go there, they're staying in hotel rooms, they pack anywhere from 5 to 10 people in a hotel room. Like I said, it's a spooky story, so this is pretty scary stuff, right? So what wound up happening for James is he went through the program, wound up being longer than he anticipated because of English being his second language. He actually failed the test a few times, but they kept bringing him back and they charged him more money. So at the end of the day, he wound up spending the same amount of money that he would have spent if he just came to a school like ours, which actually has a guaranteed program available where we can guarantee our students get a license by giving them all the training that they need, over 100 hours of training to be exact. And we're also going to give you unlimited tries at the road test, which means you pay one price. It does not matter how many times you take the test. We'll never charge you anything extra. You just keep coming back until you pass. It's kind of like an all-inclusive package if you go on vacation, right? So James wound up spending pretty much the same amount of money that he would have if he just came to a school like ours. And it wound up taking him a whole lot longer because of all the students that he had to actually go to school with. So, nevertheless, James went through the program, he spent more money, it took more time, but he got his license, so he was happy. So he started to look for work around, he started realizing that a lot of people were not hiring people right out of school, especially from schools that were kind of in that shady driver mill situation that we were talking about before, right? Because when you start working, especially the bigger companies, they want to make sure that you're going to an accredited school, just like Draven Academy is. We have to go through a lot of accreditations to make sure that our program is held to the standards that they need. In most cases, we're held to a higher standard for ourselves than what any of the trucking companies require from us. That being said, James decides to come back to New Jersey. So he actually switches his license from California to New Jersey, now having a CDL license. So James thinks everything is good. He starts looking for work, and he actually starts working with a small mom-pop company. And that's the only place he could find work because of the school that he went to. And the problem with that is the small mom-pop company didn't really have money for trucks, which means trucks kept breaking down. He was in nasty trucks all day long, kind of a truck that looks like this. Again, I told you it's a spooky story. And so as you're going forward, he's starting to make his money back, but he's getting frustrated with the work, of course, but he is limited in his options. Now comes the most spookiest part of the story. One day he gets home, he opens up the mail, he sees something from the local DMV. DMV states that his license is under review and he's going to have to become retested in New Jersey itself. So even though he went through a whole test in California and got tested in California, because Jersey is a suspicion of fraud, and especially those driver mills, he comes back to Jersey and he's going to have to get retested all over again. This is when James actually contacted us for the first time. We've seen this time and time again, and we are so sad to see this because at the end of the day, it's going to cost these people a whole lot more. So James actually came to us We did an evaluation with James. He bought a small course. He then quickly realized that he was going to need a whole lot more training just to get him ready to pass the test. So that kind of goes to tell you, James went to a whole different state, to the other side of the country, spent more money, took more time, and came back with a license. However, when he came back, he really didn't have the skills, which makes it scary that he's driving on the road with all of us around here. That's why Jersey does what it does and has people retest. So James, long story short, came to our school. We had to retrain him. It did take him longer than he thought he was going to need originally, but we wound up taking him for the test in Jersey, and he wound up passing. So now we have a happy ending. So James has now gotten his license again from us here at Driving Academy. We are now an accredited school, which means because he's a student, we help him out with free lifetime job placement. So now James is actually working for a high-end company with nice new trucks that look just like this, nice and shiny. He's making more money than he ever made before. And now he has learned his lesson. Maybe it's cheaper and quicker just to get it done with the professionals. So here at Driving Academy, we want to make sure that you're aware that yes, there's a whole lot of options of getting a CDL license out there. But we also want to make sure that you're aware of all the different downfalls that can happen if you choose other options. Here at Driving Academy, we pride ourselves in helping a million people get on the road to freedom. We are on track to getting a million people on the road to freedom, but we can only get there if we help you as well. We have a desire of helping as many people as we can. And the way that we're going to do that is providing the top quality training as much as possible. You are going to pay for the training. However, you know what you're going to get out of it. Like I said, we're one of the few schools to offer guaranteed training courses. And we are open up 7 days a week, which means you don't have to quit your job. You can come in on a part-time basis. We also have payment plans available. If you are interested, give us a call, 908-525-3609. Or click on the link below, visit our website, cdldrivingacademy.com. Fill out the form there, and one of our team members will be giving you a call shortly. And we will get you on your road to freedom. Have a happy Halloween.